In this week's space startup news, Redwire may not be as well known as some other space startups, but it plays an essential role in the space sector. Here we explore some of its current projects. VLEO, the New Frontier. You may know about Low Earth Orbit, or LEO, and Geosynchronous Orbit, GEO. But Very Low Earth Orbit, or VLEO, represents the next frontier. Satellites in VLEO fly so close to Earth that they require aerodynamic designs to avoid plunging into the atmosphere and burning up. Why do companies place satellites there? Proximity to Earth's surface enables superior imaging, delivering higher resolution and finer details, qualities that customers constantly demand. Not just commercial companies, but also the military, gain clearer views of potential threats on the ground. Redwire develops an air-breathing satellite called SabreSat. It also contributes to Phantom, a European-built satellite for intelligence gathering, Earth science and communication missions, as part of the European Space Agency's SkimSat program. Biotech. Redwire leads biotech efforts on the International Space Station. It's currently negotiating royalty agreements with major pharmaceutical companies, such as Eli Lilly and Bristol-Myers Squibb, to transform medicine production. Space stations. Redwire isn't limited to the ISS, though. They've already teamed up with future commercial space station operators. Vast Space Haven 1 will host Redwire payloads when it launches in May 2026. Redwire Europe is supplying 4 docking systems for ESA's IHAB module on the Gateway station. And Redwire is a foundational player in Orbital Reef, Blue Origin's commercial space station. The company will also provide the rollout solar array, or ROSA, solar power wings for the NASA Lunar Gateway. Although it's not clear if the Gateway station will be cancelled, our Congress will continue to fund it despite the US administration's opposition. Moon, Mars and beyond. Redwire contributes to lunar and Martian missions. It delivered core avionics and 12 flight cameras for Firefly's successful Blue Ghost lunar lander. Through its NASA-funded MASON program, Redwire creates tools to construct berms, landing pads, roads and habitats on the Moon and Mars. As a key ESA player, Redwire develops spacecraft systems for deep space exploration. It's building a comet interceptor for an ESA-led mission. With recent interstellar comets entering our solar system, ESA aims to intercept one in the future. Now, let's move on to news about a Croatian company developing a capsule. Genesis Space Flight Laboratories raised €300,000 for their Gen microgravity research spacecraft. Genesis Space Flight Laboratories, a Croatian company spun off from its Slovenian parent company, Genoplant Research, to develop a dedicated microgravity research spacecraft. The new company has just raised $300,000 in pre-seed funding. Spinning off companies happens in the US too. For instance, SNC, or Sierra Nevada Corporation, spun off a dedicated company called Sierra Space to develop the Dream Chaser vehicle. Genesis Spaceflight calls its capsule GEN, which hosts and safely returns microgravity research payloads. With the International Space Station set for deorbit by the decade's end, alternatives are needed. Commercial space stations offer one solution, while dedicated spacecraft provide another, hosting payloads briefly in orbit before deorbiting and landing safely. Varda Space already does something similar. Although it uses a satellite platform with a re-entry capsule, rather than a dedicated spacecraft, rumors suggest SpaceX has plans to outfit Starship to support dedicated microgravity research. Demand is growing for microgravity research and manufacturing, including semiconductor production, biotech, and pharmaceuticals. Less than a year ago, the company launched a modular incubator to support customer experiments in microgravity aboard a host spacecraft. The first incubator flew on the exploration company's subscale demonstrator mission, which re-entered Earth's atmosphere successfully but lost contact soon after. The company announced that it has begun work on GEN, a spacecraft intended to enable pharmaceutical research and in-space manufacturing in low Earth orbit, with the capability to then return the experimental payloads to Earth. Work has already begun on the vehicle structure, subsystem design, and a proprietary hybrid retropropulsion system powered by wax and nitrous oxide. GEN operates as an autonomous free flyer, capable of independent missions without space stations. Benka Matias, founder and CEO of Genesis, said this about the new vehicle. With GEN, we're building the missing link between Earth orbit and the scientific community, enabling important discoveries in pharmaceuticals and materials. As the ISS approaches deorbit, we felt it was our responsibility to provide an autonomous alternative, one that supports more frequent missions without the need for astronaut intervention, while keeping each launch within a reasonable budget, unquote. In 2027, the company plans to launch a GEM demonstrator, a sub-100-kilo re-entry capsule. This mission will validate the deorbit retro engine, re-entry performance, and payload recovery, demonstrating the full customer journey from launch to return. Starting with smaller vehicles allows for more frequent testing before scaling up. These iterative tests not only speed up technology validation, but also give customers regular launch slots and timely sample returns. We will track this company's progress as it advances towards a second re-entry capsule for Europe, following the European company's Nyx vehicle, which remains in development. Now, onto our final story this week. Rocket Lab launch pad photos. Rocket Lab posted some new photos of their Neutron launch pad, which is on track for an official opening next month. It's all hands on deck to complete launch pad activation, checking and verifying every system before the flight hardware arrives for Neutron's first launch. Rocket Lab's Neutron vehicle is a medium launch vehicle that is 100% fully reusable. It will be a direct competitor to SpaceX's Falcon 9, which has an almost complete monopoly on launching satellites and constellations. With this new vehicle from Rocket Lab, a high-cadence, reusable vehicle that can lift 13 tons into orbit, it will soon go head-to-head with SpaceX. Watch my video to learn more about Neutron. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this space news video, consider buying me a coffee to help fund more episodes like this. The link is in the description. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.